when do you say financial, right, substantial? Substantial change in terms and conditions. Substantial change in terms and conditions. Okay, what do we say? First, what do we calculate? I'll say A, one point, B, another point. This is difference. A minus B. Okay, whatever difference comes, E difference, okay, divided by B into 100 if you do, is it equal to or greater than? Equal to or greater than 10%. 10% of what? 10% of B. Equal to or greater than 10% of B. Then we say substantial. Then we say substantial. Fine. We'll come to the point. What is A first, sir? A is present value of. Okay, what? Present value of cash flows. Cash flows under new terms. Under new terms. I said new terms. If the financial liability is exchanged, that means for cash flows under new financial liability, you have to interpret like that. Okay. And any fees paid or minus if anything is received. Any fees received. I mean to say net. You take net. Net amount, that may be net can be a positive number, net can be a negative number. Okay. All these cash flows, when I say present value, that means are you supposed to discount it or not? Yes, you should discount it. Discount it. Using which rate, sir? Using original, that means old. Original financial liabilities, effective interest rate. Now onwards I will record effective interest rate as EIR. So use the original financial liability, that is before modification, or old financial liability. What was the effective rate of interest? That is nothing but your IRR. What you have computed. What you have learnt in the earlier classes. R rate you should apply. Discount it. Using that rate, the cash flows of the new terms. Terms, that is changed terms. Plus any fees are paid or received, whatever the net number. That is what A, your answer. Okay. Next what? Next, present value of remaining cash flows. Present value of remaining cash flows. From original financial liability. Remaining cash flows from original financial liability. Sir, here also you used present value. Present value means which discounting rate I should take. Same discounting rate. Both are discounted. Cash flows from the new terms, cash flows from the old terms. Both should be discounted using existing or old financial liabilities effective interest rate. Okay. Right. Let us say this is coming to say 100. This is coming to say 80. That is equal to 20. Yeah, 20 is this. 20 is how much percentage of 80? Yeah, 20 divided by 80 into 100. Yeah, let us say that comes to 25%. Is this 25% greater than or equal to 10%? Yes, 10% test. This is given by the standard. It is very clearly mentioned in the standard. If you say it is, yes, 25% is obviously more than 10% of B, because 10% of B comes to 8. 10% of B comes to, correct, now 10% of B comes to 8. Is this greater than 8. Yes, that means you are supposed to treat this modification or exchange as extinguishment of liability and de-recognize the existing financial liability and recognize the new financial liability. Hope you understood. Sorry. If you say I am extinguishing or I am de-recognizing financial liability either completely or in part, then what am I supposed to do? Yeah, listen. See, what do you say? First, in the balance sheet, you'll be having the carrying amount. Yeah, carrying amount. Well, that is nothing but your book value of the liability. Yeah, book value of financial liability. Yeah, let us say 100. Now, are you extinguishing? Mean, are you de-recognizing complete or part of it? Okay, right. So, now de-recognition, complete or part. Complete or partly. Yeah, complete or partly. Yes, partly means, complete means 100%. You are clearing of 100%. This means less than 100%. Less than 100% of your debt, you are clearing. Fine. If you are clearing 100%, what will happen? It's very straight. What you do in case of financial asset, same thing we'll do here also. In case of financial asset derecognition, what do we do? Correct, na? Right. What is the consideration paid? Consideration paid. Yeah. Consideration paid for derecognition or for extinguishment of liability. Consideration paid. Right. E consideration paid includes, okay, consideration paid means whatever you gave that number. In simple words, let me close it. Okay, minus carrying amount. Minus carrying amount. Yeah, carrying amount. Whatever that number, whatever the difference is coming, that will be treated as gain or loss and transfer to P&L. And transfer to P&L. This is very simple. Okay, consideration paid includes what? Whatever non-cash assets you gave. Non-cash assets given minus any liability assumed. Means assumed means you have taken over. Okay, you accepted it. Fine, what you gave and minus what is net amount. Net is what you have actually paid to other party. Minus carrying amount. Right, it's very pretty clear and simple. Fine. Whatever, what happens with respect to partly? See, partly you are paying. Correct. Whatever consideration paid, you know how much we are paying. Correct. What about carrying amount? Carrying amount ko kya karna? Because if you are partly derecognizing, that means some portion is going out. And some liability is still with you. That means one part is extinguished, one part is remaining. So how much part is gone, how much part is left? Okay. The carrying amount should be allocated. Okay, allocated. Allocated between what, sir? Between extinguished and remaining outstanding with the entity. Sir, how do you allocate? You said allocation. Correct, na? Right. What is extinguished, that portion I will bring it here. Then I will determine the gain or loss. That will be transferred to P&L. Correct, but how do you, let us say, carrying amount is equal to 100. Out of 100, how much carrying amount is gone, how much carrying amount is left over? Yeah, this what it says, You allocate in the ratio. Sir, how to allocate? Allocate in the ratio. In which ratio I should allocate it? In the ratio of relative fair values. Relative fair values. Well, fair values of what? Financial liability, which is extinguished. Which is extinguished. One second. Which is extinguished, and fair value of financial liability which is remaining. You have to find out the fair value of both. Sir, correct. A fair value means what? Fair value means, yes, you discount it using market rate of other debts. Market rate of other debts with the same terms and condition. With same terms and conditions. You use those things, and you, in examination it's not an issue. Okay, practically you have to apply a lot. In examination he will only provide you all those. Yeah, some ratio. Let us say some 2:3 ratio they gave. This is 2, this is 3. Then what am I supposed to do? 100 into 2 divided by 5. That is equal to 40. E40 is going to be deleted. You are de-recognizing it. And the difference what you paid to clear 40. Okay, some suppose I say 60 I paid. That means 20 is a loss to me. A loss, you are supposed to charge it to P&L. Okay, right. My suggestion, go through thoroughly. Right. You will be able to get better clarity. Right, pause. Yeah, let us look into now extinguishment. When did I say that you are supposed to treat as extinguishment? Extinguishment means if the terms and conditions varied, correct? No? Varied 10%, minimum 10%. Yeah, that is equal to or greater than 10% change is there, then you will say extinguishment. Otherwise, we'll treat it as and account it as a modification of existing, but we don't de-recognize. Okay, what is the accounting, sir? How do you do accounting now? With respect, if it is extinguishment, we'll take one sum and we'll solve it. If it is modification, we'll take one more sum and we'll solve it. Let us see accounting treatments. Okay, what are you supposed to do? As I said, first de-recognize existing financial liability. Yeah, that means what? Debit financial liability. Whatever original or old, whatever you call. Done. Second, then you are supposed to recognize new financial liability. At what amount, sir? Yes, if you remember, we did number of times. Any financial asset or financial liability initially should be measured at fair market value. So, yes, you bring it at fair market value. Just now I told you, how do you decide what is the fair market value? Fair market value means what? Fair market value means discounting at, correct, na? By discounting at market rate, not old or new. Effective rate of interest, effective interest rate is not applicable with respect to fair market value. E old effective rate, new effective rate is applicable only to decide whether the change change is substantial or not substantial. That's all. Okay, done. Next, third one, what are you supposed to do? Just now we decided due to derecognition you will get a recognize gain or loss from extinguishment. Yeah, from extinguishment. What is gain or loss? Just now we decided what is the carrying amount minus consideration paid. Consideration paid. Right, carrying amount minus consideration paid is nothing but our gain or loss. Okay, that is what? Gain or loss. Then what else next? Suppose if you have, okay, any incremental costs. Yeah, incremental costs. Incremental costs. Incremental costs incurred. Okay, incremental costs incurred for what? Incremental cost incurred for modifications are. We wanted to modify this. Modify this. Okay, modification of agreement. Or is it? Then modification, if it is for modification, charge to P&L. Charge to P&L. As expense. As expense. No, no, sir, this is not for modification. This is for new liability. Oh, is it? If it is for new liability, as usual, adjust it. Yeah, you learnt it number of times. Suppose you took a loan. You took a loan of 1 lakh. Fine. You paid some processing fees. You paid some anything, any incremental cost. Incremental cost. Incremental cost means these are the costs incurred only because of the loan. If I had not taken loan, I would have not incurred this. That is all incremental cost, whatever name you call. Say in my example, processing cost is equal to 2000. If it is 2000, then I will recognize the financial liability at 98,000. So if you say incremental costs are being incurred for modification, it should be charged to P&L as expense. If it is for new liability, then what are we supposed to do? Yeah, what are we supposed to do? Adjust it. Adjust it. Adjust it with. Adjust it with new financial liability. What do you mean by adjustment? This is only adjustment. You say you got 98,000 rupees. It is reduced from the total loan amount. That is what. And the next point. What are we supposed to do? Calculate. Calculate. New effective interest rate. That is means again IRR calculate. And use the same. And use the same. For the remaining period of the loan or financial liability agreement. This is the point. So what are we supposed to do? Let's recall. First, derecognize existing financial liability because it is extinguished. Second, recognize new financial liability that at fair market value. What do you say fair market value? Fair market value means by discounting the cash flows of the new financial liability with market rate. Market rate for same kind of another financial liability. Same kind means with the same terms and conditions. Okay. And recognize gain or loss. Just now we learnt gain or loss on derecognition of the financial liability partly or completely. If it is completely, that is the carrying amount minus and consideration paid. Consideration includes whatever the assets you have given minus whatever the liabilities you have assumed. Liability you have assumed is also minus liability assumed. That is what net consideration. Whatever is the difference, our difference is going to be treated as gain or loss. Okay, this is what. Let me take examples. See, I am taking examples which are given in ICAI material. Okay, same examples I am trying to explain. Anyhow, the points and the matter in that example, I am going to present it now directly. Okay, this is taken from page number ICAI material. This is from ICAI material. You can refer later. Page number 12.123. That is financial instruments mein 12.123 page number mein if you go. Right. I am writing the terms and conditions and the points given in the question. Let's have a look at it. Let us say calendar year is my year. Okay. Calendar year, not financial year, as you know. January to December. Fine. So on 1/1/2000, let me say 1/1/2000, X Limited. Okay. X Limited issued. What issued? Issued 10 years 10% bond. Bond. Okay. For what amount? 10 lakh rupees. 10 lakh rupees. 10 lakh rupees, 10% bond. Okay. And interest rate. Okay. What is the interest? Interest rate is 10%. Interest is payable. Interest is payable yearly. Yearly. That is on 31st December every year. 31st December every year. First of all, remember, this is 10 years bond. Okay. And I am not taking anything. No fees. No fees means no incremental costs. No incremental costs. That means no costs of... Okay, no transaction cost, in other words. No transaction cost. Nothing. Transaction costs are nothing but incremental costs. Okay, na? No transaction costs are incurred. Okay. Then if no transaction costs are incurred, then obviously effective interest rate is going to be 10%. Eh? If you do IRR also, same thing only will come. How can it be? Something different. Okay, what is the redemption value? Redemption value. Yeah, because redemption value is also 10 lakh. It is not, if it is more or if it is less, my effective rate of interest or IRR would have been different. Okay, yeah, this is basic. Sorry, what happened? This is first term. But on 1-1-2005, that is after 5 years. After 5 years, what has happened? There is a modification. Okay, there is a modification. Fine. What is the modification? What are the terms and conditions or modification? Okay, first, what is our last date here? Redemption value payable on 31st December 2009. It is. Because zero se start ho gaya. Correct na? 2000, 2001, 2, 3, 4, 9. That's all 10 years. But now, date is extended. Okay, extended. Till what date, sir? Till 31st December 2011. That means actually from 1-1-2005 to 31st December means 7 years are there. Correct, na? Till 2009, so 10-11. So totally 7 years are there. Sorry. Rate of interest is how much? Rate is equal to 5%. It was actually 10%. Now we changed it to 5%. Okay. What is the redemption value? Redemption value. Okay, redemption value. Redemption value is taken as 15 lakh rupees. When do you pay this money? We'll pay on 31st December 2011. Yeah, this is. And legal and other costs. Legal and other costs. Costs for modification. Legal and other cost for modification. Okay, legal and other for modification is equal to 1 lakh you incurred. 1 lakh is incurred. Cash is out. Yeah. If you remember, I told you it should be charged to P&L. If it is for modification, it should be charged to P&L as an expense, as a finance cost. Okay. Now, this is the situation, my dear. What are we supposed to do? First question, you should understand. Step 1, whatever you say. Is the change in terms and conditions are substantial? Substantial means, I said there is A, there is B, and the difference is, more than or equal to 10% of B. What is A? What is B? We are just recalling. What is A? Present value of cash flows from the new terms and conditions using existing loan financial liability effective rate of interest minus B. What is B? Present value of cash flows for the remaining period of financial liability of the original financial liability using same effective rate of interest. First, what is the book value of now answer? We are entering into the answer. We'll decide first, is it substantial modification? If it is yes, we'll account in one fashion. If it is no, we'll account in different fashion. Let us spend some time. Okay, right. Book value. Book value of, what is that? Book value of existing loan. Existing loan. On which day? On 1-1-2005. I can tell simply because your coupon rate also 10%. Effective interest rate also 10%. So obviously there will not be any change in the 10 lakh rupees. That is principal amount. Yeah, how sir? How means, let us say 0,000. You have a loan of opening balance of how much? 10 lakh. What is the interest? Interest at which rate? Interest at effective interest rate, that is equal to 10%. Okay, and what do you make payment? We'll make payment as per the terms, which is equal to 10%. Okay, at the rate of 10% means it will come to 1 lakh. What you make payment also? 1 lakh. That is closing balance is equal to 10 lakh, which is 10 lakh plus 10 lakh plus 1 lakh minus 1 lakh is equal to 10 lakh. If the same thing is repeated on 31st December 2004, obviously my 10 lakh, which is equal to book value on 1/1/2005. Means same 10 lakh will come 1 lakh plus 1, 1 plus 1 lakh minus 1 lakh plus 1 lakh minus 1 lakh. So it's getting repeated obviously. 10 lakh is the one. Sorry, this is just a carrying amount purpose. I just kept it aside. Book value we found just one point. Second point. Yeah, I just want to repeat A minus B. Correct, na? Right. That difference we are supposed to compute. Again, I repeat. Okay, A is what? Present value of cash flows as per new terms plus any fees paid. Minus received, whatever it is, net fees what you paid. This you should be using effective. So existing first original financial liability effective interest rate is equal to 10%, which is given in the sum directly. Fine. Now let us calculate this. What are the present value terms? Loan amount is this one. So interest will come to how much? Interest will come to 10 lakh into 5%, which is equal to 50,000. And so e interest you are supposed to pay for 7 years. Correct, na? 7 years. First, if I calculate cash flows, year zero, I mean today in the sense 1/1/2005, I am paying. What am I paying? 1 lakh rupees. Because the fees, what are legal fees, just now we wrote, legal fees is paid 1 lakh. Okay, sorry. 1 to 7 years. Just because my extended period is till 31st December 2011. So, I have to pay 50,000 like the 7 years. And in the 7th year. I am supposed to pay 15 lakh rupees. Yeah, 15 lakh rupees. If you discount it at the rate of 10%, which is existing rate, now you will get present value cash flows. See, I already computed. I am just getting you the direct answer. You can do it later, aramse. Okay, it comes to 11,13,158 rupees. It's coming after discounting all these cash flows. We are through with A. Now, what is the next one? Next one is present value. Present value of cash flows for the remaining, correct, na? For remaining term of original financial liability. Okay, so original terms, what is original term? Original term year, cash flows at the rate of 10%, because other rate, correct, na? So present value cash flows. Yeah, what is original term? Original term prakara, this is actually 5 years. So 1 to 5 years. How much do you pay interest? Interest I will pay 1 lakh. How did you get 1 lakh? 10 lakh into 10%. Okay, we'll apply that. Next, and in the 5th year, that is on 31st December 2009. What are you supposed to pay as per the original term? 10 lakh you should pay. If you discount it, obviously it will come to 10 lakh. Okay, right, nothing else will come. You can check later. So now we are through. This is A, this is B. Now what is the difference? Yeah, difference is how much, sir? Difference is 1,13,158. Okay, right. See, first of all, what is 10% of B? 10% of B is 1 lakh. Is it 1 lakh for 13,000 is more than 1 lakh? Yes, that means the terms are substantially changed. That means you have to extinguish the liability and correct, you have to extinguish the liability. So how much is the change? What is the change percentage? Okay, change percentage 1,13,158 divided by 10 lakh into 100. Obviously, it comes to 11.34%, which is greater than 10% as given by the standard. So, extinguish. Extinguishment. So, it is extinguishment. Okay. Let's revise once. If it is extinguishment, what are we supposed to do? First, derecognize the old financial liability. Two, recognize new financial liability at the present value, present fair market value. What is fair market value? Using the market rate. Yeah. In the question, I forgot to give actually one point. Okay, right. Today market rate, you know, today market rate is 11% they gave in the question already. Okay, so that means the terms and the new terms and conditions are supposed to be discounted at 11%. Let's see what with the fair market value you are going to get. Okay, and you lost 1 lakh rupees already. That is supposed to be, that is because of the modification. That should be charged to P&L. Fine, okay. Let us record it. Record all these things one by one. So first, see, the old carrying amount, I know 10 lakh rupees. I will do it. But I have to recognize the new financial liability. Okay, so let me first find out it. Then we will recognize the one, record one journal entry. So that it will be perfectly alright. Yeah. So first, present value, fair market value of new financial liability. Right. What is the fair market value of financial liability? Year, cash flows at the rate of 11%. 11% is market rate. 11% is market rate. Then present value or fair value, whatever you say. Year, zero. Nothing. Because 1 lakh is not because of the new financial liability. 1 lakh is for, 1 lakh I shouldn't take it. 1 lakh is for modification. So I don't consider 1 lakh for my this. Okay, 1 to 7 years I will be paying 50,000. And 7th year I will be paying 15 lakh. At the rate of 11%, if you apply present value factor, annuity factor, etc., your liability will come to, I have the answer, 958,097. Okay. Right. This is the new one. So, now let us record. What is the journal entry? Profit or loss is the balancing figure. I can take it aramse. Okay. That will be charged to P&L. What did they say first? Derecognize old. So, liability shows a debit credit balance. Debit it and derecognize it. So, old financial liability. Okay, that is like 10% bonds. Can I say 10% bonds? Right, I am saying debit. How much? 10 lakh. Okay, 2. What is that? 5% bonds. 5% bonds is the new financial liability. New financial liability. Okay, new financial liability. This is this number. Correct, na? 9,58,097. Because financial liability, initially, it's a new one. New one, recognizing the new liability. New one should be always recognized at fair market value. That is our basic understanding. Okay, two, cash. What is this cash? Cash is that legal fees paid for modification. Legal fees for modification. Okay, legal fees for modification. Actually, from the liability, actually 10 lakh minus 958, you got a gain. But you lost 1 lakh rupees, that's why net is what, that is what you will say, finance cost. This is a loss to you in total. This is what my balancing figure. I can take it directly. That comes to 58,097. This amount should be transferred to P&L. This is what? That sum. Okay? Right. Hope you understand. You revise once again, you will get better clarity. Okay. Let's